Lisa Ann Sandell, and I'm really excited to be the Readergirlz author in residence for the next few months. I want to thank the Readergirlz divas for having me. So I thought I'd start my first blog or vlog post by telling you guys a little bit about the beginning of my creative process, how ideas come to me, where I go for inspiration, and how it all shakes out at the start. So I'm going to take you outside because I draw a lot of my inspiration from nature, and I'll show you some special spots. You might think New York City doesn't have that much nature, but you would be wrong. My dog Molly and I are going to go for a walk, and I'll show you. To Joan of Arc Island. It's a little park a block from my apartment. It's one of Molly's favorite spots, and it's where I like to go to start thinking about storyline and character ideas. It's where the ideas really begin to percolate and come together. Molly likes to sniff. So you can see there are lots of gardens, lots of trees. It's very idyllic here, and I just like to walk up and down the paths and think, let ideas come to me. Sculpture of Joan of Arc, hence the name of the park. I love to look up at this sculpture. I think it's so powerful, and Joan of Arc is such an amazing symbol of feminine strength and courage. I like to write about those kinds of heroines. And I'm a sculptor, so I enjoy just the aesthetics of it. Here in Riverside Park. It's my favorite park in New York City, and I think it's amazing because here we are on street level, and you just go down those steps there, through the tunnel, underneath the highway, and then you'll see we'll be right down by the Hudson River. Come on! Down here and sit on one of these benches with a notebook and pen and record whatever comes into my mind. Sit down here by the river and look out at the water. Water has always inspired me. I'm not sure why, but I've somehow ended up including a scene involving water in all of my books. And here's a short one from Song of the Sparrow. I hurry past the river, and the sound of water rushing over stones slows my feet. I stop and look at the grassy bank. Reeds, brown and green in the sunlight, gently sway with the breeze. The scent of damp decay reaches my nostrils, and I slip off my leather slippers and step gingerly down to the river's edge, letting the black mud ooze between my toes, warm and deliciously thick. Well, that's it for now, but I'll look forward to hearing from you, and maybe you'll want to let me know which some of your creative processes are. And I'll be in touch with more blog and vlog posts in the coming weeks and months. Thank you.